Today we're going to build a menace arm or pipe boom rig. To start off with, we need a combo stand, sandbags, pipe. In this case, we have 1¼-inch pipe in 5-foot lengths to create our boom. We have pipe joiners to bring the sections together, and we have the menace arm or pipe boom kit. To begin building our menace arm or pipe boom, we're going to start by adding a fathead or 4½-inch gobo head to the combo stand. So I add the head to the stand. I want to make sure that my overhand rule is working in my favor. I'm going to have the arm reach out over in that direction. The center of the pipe boom rig or menace arm slides into the fat head and slides over. So that ear is in place. And I want to make sure my overhand rule is helping me with that. With that in place, I'm ready to add my first section of pipe. After that, I'm ready to add a pipe joiner. I want to keep track of about how much I'm inserting into that joiner and tighten. With my pipe joiner in place, I bring in another piece of pipe and tighten it down. Now this is the tail section of the pipe rig. Depending on what instrument I'm using overhead on the target area, I'm going to use the opposite end on the tail. So in this case, I have a junior receiver plate, and since I won't be hanging any juniors today, I will use that on the tail. And notice that it has a ring here to receive the hook from the ratchet strap, which we're going to attach in just a moment. To make sure that we have enough reach overhead, we're going to add another section of pipe. Now, our sections we have cut into 5-foot lengths, but you can easily get pipe in longer lengths to reduce the amount of joiners that you have to use. So just adding our extra length of pipe here, you're going to see that the longer it stretches out, the more the boom arm actually dips down a little bit. So we're going to have to counterbalance that when it gets to that point. So this is going to be our target area, the area at the end of the pull. And so in this case, I'm going to add a piece that has baby spuds both on the top and the bottom, and my ringlet on the top to grab a hold of the ratchet strap. So with our particular kit, we've already got the sizes measured out, so you shouldn't have to do too much adjusting of the ratchet straps. But if you're building your own kit, you obviously want to use a heavy-duty ratchet strap. So I'm going to hook that into the eyelet here and take it back to the center of the rig. So with the first leg in play, I need to add the second ratchet strap to the center and the tail. Tighten, loosen up, take up the slack. And this ratcheting action actually pulls the target end of the boom up a little to help counterbalance the weight that we're going to add to it. We can also add some ballast or counterweight on the tail end of this by using a sandbag or a shot bag. Depending on how heavy the fixture is on the target end of this, I may need that extra weight, or I may not. So on the end of the boom, I'm going to hang a midget. And I want to make sure that I'm tightening into the area of that baby spud that is ready to receive that. You can use a number 2 clip to secure the cord along the way so it doesn't sag down. Be careful not to pinch the cord. We want to make sure and have ample support and weight on the combo stand holding the menace arm. When we're setting up our menace arm, we want to make sure that the weight of the arm is actually extended over one of the legs of the combo stand. So the last step is to actually lift the rig up. We've built it at the minimum height of this combo stand, but to play in the scene, we wanted to actually raise it up into the ceiling. To do that, with the amount of weight that's on here, sandbags, fixture, pipe, it may be in your best interest to get a grip helper at this point. If I want to turn or rotate the arm in any way, within reason, I remember to keep balance over one of the legs, but if I need to move it back an inch or two, I could turn one of the risers here or loosen one of the risers here and rotate at that point. So I can do it safely without the whole device crashing down. With the length of the combo stand, I have really only about 10 foot of usable space underneath this Menace arm rig. Unlike a goalpost, I have complete clearance of everything except for the space where the single combo stand is. Next, in one of the other videos, we'll set up a goalpost unit using much of the same rigging, but without the anxiety of the Menace arm rig. Be careful when taking down the Menace arm rig. We also want to make sure that as we disassemble the unit that we're not going to hurt ourselves or anybody around us. So first we're going to bring the unit down to working height and then release the weights and instruments and ratchet straps and finally disassemble the piece.